Hello. That was Dolce. Sorry. Let's try this again. Hello.
First off, welcome. God damn it, welcome.
It's LaLa. Welcome to your quarantine edition of Ask LaLa. We are going to answer 7 relationship questions today. And I'm only giving you my perspective, you know? Feel free to put yours in the comments because I want to know. And we can have a dialogue. I'm always open to that. So keep that in mind. Let's just get started. Question number 1. What advice would you give yourself before entering the relationship you're currently in? That's a good question. I would say, LaLa, be patient. Rome was not built in a day. And hard times don't last always. So when y'all hit a rough patch, peace be still. And just see how he reacts. Because he's not who you were with. So you have to take him for who he is and allow him the opportunity to be him and show you who he is in good times and in strife, and then make an informed decision that way. I would also say expect it to be unconventional, because in 2020, it's not how it was 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago. It's different now. So while you don't have to subject or compromise your morals and integrity in any way, you have to understand that you're treading in new waters and in uncharted territories for you. And you just have to be patient with yourself, with the firm understanding that you've always been adaptable to change. This should be no different. And if he means something to you, you'll do it. That would be my advice to myself. Question number 2. Is your partner preventing you from being the person you need to be? Absolutely not. My answer is no. I'm gonna be everything I need to be for me first. You know what I mean? Alone or in a partnership. I still have my obligations, as does he. And this train was going before y'all cabooses combined. So keep it moving. Number 3, what type of family do you want to have with your partner? That's easy. I want a happy family. I want a balanced family. I want a loving family. That's what I want. I want a home of love. I want our blend of children to know that they're loved from everybody in their life. Everybody in their mom's life, everybody in their dad's life, everybody loves them and are loved. And I don't want anybody in my family walking away feeling unloved in any way, because love is very necessary, never more than today. Number 4. Do you really feel that you're pushing hard enough with your partner, or do you feel like you're settling? I'll never settle for anything in life. I've learned that that is counterproductive, so I'm never settling. Pushing hard enough, we can always push and do more. Always. Always. So there's that one's a question where no, I'll never settle, because I did that already. I'm not settling again. And am I being pushed hard enough Or am I pushing myself hard enough? I think I am. And he supports me in my endeavors, and I appreciate that. I respect him so much for that. Question number 5. How has having children or not having children affected your relationship? Children haven't affected anything because we both have our own children separately. So he has his kids, I have my kids. We're Gucci. Do you avoid conflict in your relationship? Absolutely, I do. Because I lean more towards peace than anything. And one piece of advice that I can give women who are unaware, because some queens already know, but for the ones that don't, no man wants to be in a toxic relationship. No man wants to be badgered. No one wants to be accused of things that they may or may not have done. If you got concrete evidence, there's no, you know what I mean? That's one thing. But to accuse somebody or to nag somebody about some things because you're just of the insecurities you have within you, or your esteem isn't as high as it should be within you, and you're projecting it onto him, that's not fair to him. And I'll be the first woman to say it. It's not fair. It's not fair at all. The men have enough, black men have enough against them without adding their lady to it. You don't want to do that. You want to send a man off to go make his money with positive vibes and energy. Okay? You don't want to unsettle his spirit in any way, shape, or form. Whatever you have that you need to say to him that you feel like or you know that will upset him, wait till he comes home. He's winding down, not as soon as he walks in the door, because he's just now seeing you after 8, 10, 12, 16, whatever hours. He want to be happy to see you. He want to be greeted. No matter what he smell like, with a kiss at least, a hug, a smile. Welcome home, baby. Food gonna be ready in a second, babe. Type thing, you know? Rather than as soon as he walk in the door, so where the fuck you been? Type shit. You know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't want that. So I do to people what I want done to me. I just don't do that. You send that man out to make his money, positive vibes. During his day, positive vibes. You wanna add, you wanna get some extra points, go bring him some pussy for lunch. And some lunch. You know what I mean? But on a day-to-day, regular, everyday, don't argue with that man for no reason over some inconsequential shit that won't matter in 5 minutes. Leave that man alone and let him live. We all human. We make mistakes. I'm not talking about cheating and, you know, being aggressive or being violent or, you know, being abusive in any way. I'm talking about everyday mundane things, just regular conversation. Can we have a dialogue where we don't have to argue in every conversation? Every woman wants that, and so does every man. And what you have to understand as a woman is that you have the ability, because he has feelings for you, that you can push those buttons, and you're gonna push them a different way than a stranger would, or his mama would, or anybody would. And you have to just be careful of that, because a man's pride, his dignity, his respect, that means everything to him. Society may make you, lead you to believe that that is not true, but them men are raised where all they have is their name and their respect. And if they can't get respect from their woman, what are they doing there? Why are you there? Why am I with you if you're not even gonna respect me? Respect should be a minimum. And the first thing you gotta do is respect that man's head space and his time when he's out making money, and allow him to do so. Please, just try that. If you haven't tried that yet, try that. I promise you it'll work. I promise you. It's gonna bring you peace and bring your pressure down, and his as well. And the last question is, what's something you really need from your partner? I have a few things that I need. I need his support. When he's seeing me push towards something, I need his support, just like he needs mine. I need his love and affection. I need his attention when he's available, with the understanding, firm understanding, he's a busy man. And when you're dealing with a busy man, he's not gonna be available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But a busy man that carves out time out of his schedule to come and make time with you should not go unnoticed. And you should not be ungrateful about it. Because there are women who are begging men, shit, hell, I say pay men for attention. When he's making sure he gives it to you, it may not be much. He may be exhausted. You may have to, you know, while he trying to show you some attention, you may have to show him some. If it's been a long day, rub that man back, give him a massage, rub his feet, clip his toenails, you know what I'm saying? Whatever you need to do, get his ingrown hairs, whatever he needs from you, do it. That's your man. You know what I mean? I require. I don't give a damn if every other man in the world, well, I don't even have to, it don't even apply because he called me beautiful like it's my name, but men, make sure you're acknowledging the time your woman puts in the effort into keeping herself up and getting herself ready. While we don't do that for you, we still want the acknowledgement from you, because I guarantee you when she walks out of that door and goes to wherever she's going to, men are paying her that compliment. So her man at home, she's going to notice that she gets it from everywhere but home. That's the least, if you even got to tell a man to do that. Gratefully, I don't. So, but I just wanted to put that out there. Words of affirmation, you know what I'm saying? And all of that is sweet and good, but I also need him to get in my ass when he sees that I'm slacking. And I want him to remind me of the shit that I told him that I said I was gonna do. Well, what happened? You said you was gonna do ABC. What happened with that type thing? You know what I'm saying? Like, just check me, because I may have forgot. And without him saying something to me, I didn't remember till he said something. You know? Don't nag me, but, you know, that's how you push each other. You hold each other accountable for our words. And if we say we're going to do something, do it. That's the best thing you could ever do for your relationship, is if you say you're going to do something, to do it. And that's it for this quarantine edition of Ask a LaLa. How did you answer these questions? I hope they're in the comments below. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time.